So you're telling me that if I were to walk upstairs, I could technically drive the car from upstairs?
Yes, definitely.
Don't you want to put that to a test?
Yeah, let's do it.
Jeg befinder mig i Budapest her på Bosch's store campus i Ungarn. Grunden til at gøre det er, at jeg er hernede for at finde ud af, hvad for en størrelse Bosch egentlig er. De fleste tænker måske, at de laver skruemaskiner og køkkenredskaber, men nej, Bosch er en markant større størrelse. De har mere end 430.000 ansatte worldwide, og så er de altså en af verdens førende inden for bilindustrien, når det kommer til teknologi. Derfor skal jeg møde nogle af verdens førende eksperter. Jeg er enormt spændt på at møde dem, jeg er enormt spændt på at lære, og så er jeg sikker på, at vi nok skal blive bombarderet med en masse information. Jeg nok skal prøve at, skal man sige, translate til et sprog, vi kan forstå os herhjemme. Så i stedet for, at jeg står og snakker om det, så lad os gå ind og høre fra eksperterne dem selv. Det er dem, der har styr på det.
Gyula, pleasure to meet you.
Hey, Jacob.
Jacob.
Nice to meet you. So I'm an engineer, so I like to play with gadgets. Yeah. And this is the most expensive and biggest gadget that I have.
I denne episode møder vi Gyula. Han er en teknologientusiast og en senior ekspert hos Bosch, der arbejder med cloud og automatisering.
Hans mission er at drive innovation i virksomheden og være i stand til at anvende de nye teknologier på en meningsfuld måde, vi andre kan gøre brug af.
So basically this is a car that can be remotely controlled through 5G. We have GPS on this car and we have 4 cameras inside the car so that you can follow it from upstairs how it goes. So basically this is the soul of the car. But what you can see, which is really important for us, is a 5G modem. So we have the 5G antennas up there.
Uh-huh.
And basically we have 2 cells that operate in this test track. And this is the soul of the car, and then you can see all the wires go up towards the driving, and basically that's how we control the cars. And the main thing, why did we came up with this?
Yeah.
So that we can automate testing. So many times testers, they do like the same test 100 times or 200 times, and it can take up so much time. And you know, when it's cold like now,
yeah,
it's much better sitting in the office and driving your car from upstairs.
So I'm thinking initially, you know, it sounds cool, the fact that you can drive the car from somewhere else.
Yes.
In terms of a safety perspective, how safe is it, you know, and how good is the connection?
That's why we choose 5G.
Okay.
So we have tested it with Wi-Fi. So you will say, you can see we have Wi-Fi connection all over the test track.
Yeah.
When it's standing, so stationary, mm-hmm. it works really nice.
Okay.
But once you start driving the car and then it starts hopping between the access points,
yeah.
then you will see dropping connections, packet loss.
Yeah.
And you know, like packet loss is the worst. It's the worst, right? So with this one, we cannot allow packet loss. And with 5G, we can actually do prioritization of the different data channels. Of course, if you get some hardware malfunction in the 5G, then the car just stops.
Okay.
Right,
so seems like it's safe to
It has to be safe, like safety first. That's
okay.
Our motto,
safety
right?
first, of course.
Yes.
So you're telling me that if I were to walk upstairs, I could technically drive the car from upstairs.
Yes, definitely.
Don't you want to put that to a test?
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah.
Let's see a race between you
let's
and
see
me.
A race, yeah.
Who's the better
gamer?
Yeah, right.
So good. I'm quite interested in obviously knowing that you can drive the car remotely. How can that be applied in the real world? Like for what good cause?
There are already companies in other parts of the world where they are using huge fleets of remotely controlled drives where you have people sitting in offices and driving the cars.
Instead of being in the car, you could meet
you can work from
office.
Home, yeah, right?
Exactly.
So it's a home office, right?
Okay.
And then you basically transport people all over the world.
All right, Gyula, so this is your gaming setup.
Yes, so this is our workstation, as you can see.
Workstation.
In the middle screen, from the car, you can see like a virtual wheel, etc. In the middle screen, once the car is online, you will be able to see the cameras from the car. You can see like a virtual wheel, so that you can see what's happening in the car. And on the right, screen, you can see the test track itself.
Okay. Somewhat normal looking gaming setup with a bit of a nerdy metrics on each side, yeah?
Yes.
So I know now we're roughly, what, 50 meters away from the car or something? Or 20 meters
more.
Away, or even more, yeah?
It's like 200 meters.
200 meters away, and if we were to be 5 kilometers away, would it work the same way?
Or yes, it wouldn't matter.
Completely, yeah.
Mondo.
Så lige nu er han i gang med at connect bilen på netværket. Han har en gut nede i bilen, der ringer til ham, og så skulle de gerne kunne connect bilen op, så William lidt kan se og styre bilen heroppefra. So the car is up and running now?
Yes. From now on, we can press the gas and the car will start.
Okay.
And then you can see now the GPS coordinates is also updated.
Yeah.
So the car moves to the location.
It follows my track, yeah.
Exactly.
Gotcha.
So we will see there as well how you go. You will also see the cameras, how you will go. And when I'm driving, uh-huh. you will be downstairs.
Okay.
It will be really weird.
Okay.
Because you will see the car
yeah.
turning without anyone touching it. So
okay.
it's like a drone, really.
Sure, yeah. My life car. Is in your hands, yeah.
Exactly, with all that 5 kilometers per hour.
Let's do rock, paper, scissors as to who goes first.
Okay,
yeah?
Let's do this. 1, 2, 3.
There we
oh
go.
My God, Jaco.
I go first,
you
I go first.
First.
I go first.
We built this test track. Starts with a slalom. Then there is a little kid, which we shouldn't hit. Do a 360. Then come next to this car and then just do a parallel parking.
So I could sit down now and we could get going?
Yes.
All right. Speeder, brake.
Yes, you don't need clutch.
No, okay. I'm ready.
Okay, ready, set, go. And it's super fast.
And the acceleration.
yeah, it's crazy.
I have no idea, yeah. As you said, like you have no idea. Okay.
I think you are already better than me. I'm a bit nervous, actually.
You're nervous. That kid right there should be
yeah.
nervous. Okay, so far so good.
Yeah. Okay, the kid is safe.
Kid is safe, okay. So far so good.
Really nice.
Can I make it?
Yes.
I think I made it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Easily.
Yeah, it didn't hit anything.
No.
This is going significantly better than I thought. But you're right in saying, like, I don't know how close.
Yeah. That's hard part, so yeah. you can, it's fine.
Yeah.
Just go straight.
Uh-huh. Oh, no. This is not going too well. There we go. We're messing it up now.
You can always do some corrections. And now you hit the dummy. Because you need to switch to drive.
That's
perfect.
As good as it gets.
Yeah.
There we go. Done.
Perfect, Jacob.
Only one crash. I'll jump down and you get yeah. to control
perfect.
My life, I guess. Yeah?
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, I'll see you in a bit.
See you. I think he hit the dummy, but other than that, I think he was really fast. Let's hope I can make it just as good as Jacob.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay, let's do this.
All right, slow start, slow start.
Slow start, that's the most I can.
Try not to hit the cones.
Stay to the right.
No helping.
No, he's with me.
Two against one, huh? There's a little kid on the road, try not to hit him.
Colin McRae would be happy. Oh.
Ooh, that wasn't smooth. You're a bad driver.
Thank you. Okay, let's do the 360.
That's a very wide 360. Yeah, take your time. I'd even argue mine was better.
Yeah.
Yeah?
What are you laughing there?
Nothing, take your time, it's all good. Okay. We got all day.
Thank you, I'm done. It's nice, I'm in my place.
Gyulan, get down here. I think we need to solve this once and for all.
Okay, Jacob, let's discuss. Ciao.
So how did you feel inside the car?
It's a fun experience, and I can definitely see the purpose of it, you know, as we spoke about, you know, let's say that you need someone to pick you up somewhere and they can do it for home, you know.
And exactly, and then you just sit back.
Yeah.
And then you see that, of course, it's yeah. a regular car. So you have yeah. the wheel mm. inside, mm. which is perfectly fine.
You think that's the future of cars as well, that some cars will be made without a wheel at all?
I believe so, yes.
Yeah?
I mean, there's no real purpose. And what about the race?
I think you were pretty slow, you know.
Really?
I think you had a slow start, but listen, who won the race?
This is how it went down. So Jacob,
uh-huh.
you were 3 minutes and 50 seconds.
Wow, okay.
But you had a 10-second penalty.
10 seconds?
Only not 10?
A, yeah, 10-second penalty.
Okay.
So your ending time was 4 minutes, 0.0 seconds.
Any style points? My parking was way better than his.
Sure, but no.
No, okay, sick.
Gyula,
yes.
So, Jacob had 4 minutes, 0.0 seconds. Gyula had 4 minutes, 0.3 seconds.
Okay.
So Jacob won with 3 seconds.
Yep, that's fair.
It's okay.
Perfect. Gyula, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you
Thank
so much.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Tusind tak for at have fulgt med i min lille minirejse hernede i Budapest på Bosch's campus. Som sagt allerede, som I har set, jamen, så er der masser af den her teknologi, vi støder på til dagligt. Så hvorvidt det er jeres telefon, I tager frem, hvorvidt det sætter ind i en bil, jamen, så vil I støde på noget af Bosch's teknologi. Det anede jeg ikke, da jeg kom ned, og jeg anede heller ikke, at de var i gang med at innovere så meget, som de er. Så jeg håber, at I har fået lige så meget ud af at følge med her, som jeg har. Det var en fornøjelse at fremvise det for jer, og jeg håber, I har nydt det. Hvis I fandt den her episode interessant, så husk på, at der er 2 episoder mere, I kan finde på Bosch's YouTube-kanal eller på deres hjemmeside.